I started audition itu untuk film itu dari tahun 2002 kali 2003. And then I got my first movie 2007. So it took 5 years almost. Dari 2002 2003 sampai ke 2007 itu I think puluhan mungkin ratusan kali. Enggak pernah dapet. Tapi I keep going. Gue tetap datang aja kalau ada audisi di mana aja gue datang. And then gue ngerasa ya kalau Thomas Alva Edison hampir 10.000 untuk dapetin penemu lampu pijar. Kenapa gue baru 50 atau 100 gue harus give up gitu. Pasti ada yang nyantol gitu. Pasti ada. You just have to believe in that. And I believe in that. Jadi gue, I keep going. And then, yeah, I get my first role. Casting, sebenarnya 1-10 casting yang gue datang, gue shaking. Gue di depan kamera tuh kaki gue kelihatan gitu. Yang megang kamera tahu banget kalau gue gemeteran sampai ketawa-ketawa, diketawain lah pokoknya. Ngomong kadang-kadang nggak bisa gitu. Karena gue tuh orangnya dari kecil kalau gue nyanyi di depan kelas tuh gue bisa gemeteran gitu. But karena gue dibesan like I said, it's very competitive life. Jadi gue ngerasa kalau gue terus-terusan nggak mungkin gue gini terus gitu. Jadi 1-10 shaking, 10-20 I get better, tapi 20-30 gue bisa improv, 30-40 gue bisa mulai dapat emosinya segala macam. So it's improving. So, setiap kesalahan yang gue buat, gue ngerasa 1-10 itu gue dapetin pelajaran baru. So because gue nggak pernah sekolah acting sebelumnya. Jadi learning by doing and learning from your mistake is the best teacher, I think. Mungkin lebih ke persiapan sih. And then every time you want to go for audition, you have to make sure that you're ready more than everybody else. Karma, rasa, the rate, deadline, fast and furious, pelatasan. For me, ya, acting itu, for my opinion is to be someone that you're not. And then in order to be someone you're not, you have to train. You have to believe that you're not. You know, you have to believe that character is not you. So I think that's the simple say acting is like that. Oh, pasti script sih, pastinya sih. Cerita dulu, the script has to be really really good, and I have kind of like attached with the script and the character. Kalau director sebenarnya ya. Ya gue pernah kerja sama director yang bagus yang udah banyak jam terbang, dan gue pernah kerja sama director yang baru pertama kali bikin film. Tapi after meeting biasanya setelah ketemu you kind of feel it. You kind of feel like gue bisa nggak kerja bareng dia gitu. So it's not about you work with only the top directors. Sometimes you just have to believe someone that baru bikin film but you have that energy. I think it's still struggling ya. Lebih simpelnya kita film Indonesia ya, struggle-nya untuk semua ya, filmmaker, actors, kita harus jadi tuan rumah di negeri sendiri sih. Jadi untuk dapetin penonton sih, which is sekarang juga masih kurang kan, penonton kita juga, they don't really have the confidence of our movie. And then, sebelum itu dapet, yang lain gak bakal bisa berkembang. You know? Step pertama yang paling penting, we have to get our audience, our local audience to support us. So, kalau itu gak dapet ya gak bisa. You know, because comparison-nya orang Indonesia kalau nonton film pasti film Hong Kong, Jepang, Korea, Hollywood. Jadi in order to dapetin mereka attention ya, kita harus at least the quality. Quality-nya kita harus minimal ya bersaing sih. No matter how good the story is, kalau first 5 minute tiba-tiba gambar ada yang blur atau tiba-tiba suaranya enggak clear, itu akan ngefek orang nonton film sampai habis. Jadi kayak nonton sesuatu dia udah down gitu. Ah, so when the expectation is sudah down, udah enggak percaya lagi, build-nya udah lebih susah. You know? First scene, first 5 minutes is very important for all the audience. Here, we're bilang the rate ya. Yeah. I'm gonna say the rate. It's my favorite. Of course, I mean it. The rate, gue bilang salah satu film Indonesia yang bikin negara ini dilihat dari segala faktor. Got me Fast Six, got me Hollywood career. My dream role is to play a drama.
Yeah?
A drama, like a father and son story.
Why?
I have a kid, I love my kid so much. I think I have that, you know, something that I can deliver. Al Pacino, he's the inspiration. He's the inspiration, you know. Gue serius untuk jadi pemain film, serius untuk jadi seorang aktor when I watch Godfather 2. Ada satu scene yang dia mukul, dia marah lah sama istrinya di satu ruangan, and it's very very good. I want to be like him. I want to do what he does, something like that. I want to be an actor. Ya, itu salah satu one of the reasons that kenapa gua gagal sampai butuh 5 tahun untuk gua dapetin role. Mereka pasti bikin role-nya karakternya orang Indonesia. Secara believable, gua enggak bisa masuk. It's impossible. Sometimes kan di Indonesia ada jelas itu Jawa atau Sunda atau apa. For me to go the audition for that role, first 5 seconds casting director bilang, it's not that role. It's not that character." Gua hanya bisa dapat peran di mana kalau direkturnya agak-agak mau berani gambling, atau karakter itu ya boyfriend from Hong Kong or whatever, Yakuza from Japan. Oh yeah, he did big gamble, because my role in Raid is I'm the leader of SWAT team from Indonesia. If you watch in reality, there's no way somebody look like me to be a leader in a pasukan khusus polisi. Come on, it's impossible. So for me, it's a big gamble because Garrett think universal sih. Dia berpikir secara universal, dia berpikir secara global, international vision. So what gitu. It's a movie, you know. Sebelum Obama jadi presiden juga, kan Morgan Freeman udah jadi presiden Amerika. So things nggak harusnya nggak ada limit apapun yang membatasin itu. Oh, gue jarang nangis. Jarang banget. That's gonna be a big homework for me. Oh, pernah. Baru-baru ini sih. Schindler List.
Okay.
Ya, yeah, itu gua harus, kalau gua enggak nangis gua bukan manusia sih. I don't think so. I'm ugly. Come on. Kalau enggak ada achievement itu mungkin enggak mungkin, you know. And people think this is the idea of people think I'm good looking because but in reality I'm not, right? Kalau untuk cita-cita, untuk aim high of course sih, kalau emang masa kita kalau orang jadi aktor di Indonesia terus gue maunya di sini aja gitu, pasti gue rasa semua orang pengen ngelebarin sayap lebih. It's positive sih kalau emang inspirasinya begitu positif, jadi orang lebih semangat, jadi orang lebih ngerasa, oh kalau dia bisa kenapa gue nggak bisa, Joe aja bisa kenapa gue nggak bisa. Gue dengar itu gue seneng banget, which is it kind of like open the door and people like udah rebutan untuk masuk gitu. Jadi I'm very lucky, you know, to be the guy that yang bisa. At least it's not impossible now, you know, it's not impossible. My project, Red Redemption, again. Red Redemption got me everything. Forever till I die.
Yeah.
Planning to be a filmmaker someday, but not now, maybe next 10 years.
Cool.
Hati-hati loh, saingan ntar.
Ha 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 ha.